Celsius has been a rapidly growing brand and company, gaining a lot of popularity over the past couple of years. The stock is also up 3,000% the past 5 years as well, which is amazing for investors. But more recently, growth has slowed down, and we had an all-time high of $95 a share in May of 2024. We're down 47%, almost 50% in Celsius stock. Is now a time to buy? Is the growth still there? Is the value still there? Or is the Celsius story completely over? We'll break that all down in this video. Celsius Holdings is known for its fitness drinks, which claim to accelerate metabolism and burn body fat. The company has grown massively past 5 years with a CAGR of over 50%, and growth is still expected, although a bit weaker recently. We'll discuss why that's the case. The management team over there has demonstrated a strong ability to navigate uncertain market conditions and manage rapid growth effectively, which is a positive indicator for the company's future, of course. Despite recent challenges, again, Celsius has maintained efficient inventory management, which is huge, with inventory turns above the 3-year average and days outstanding inventory significantly lower than peak levels. While Celsius does trade at a higher valuation, 42 times forward earnings, it's cheaper compared to past levels, with this 50% fall off in the stock price, of course. If the company can continue to perform well, there's potential for the valuation gap between Celsius and competitors like Monster to widen favorably for Celsius. They also achieved an 11.5% market share, a notable feat in the competitive energy drink sector, indicating strong brand presence and customer loyalty. And historically, Celsius has consistently beaten quarterly revenue estimates, highlighting the company's ability to exceed market expectations. And for some more on their financials here, just to show you guys how well Celsius is doing, we have revenue up to $1.4 billion, growing rapidly again every year. Gross profit, $700 million, of course, growing super rapidly. 2020, we had $61 million in gross profit. Operating income as well, barely positive, sometimes massively negative, but now up to $300 million. We have net income as well, positive $200 million. Great stuff there. Shares outstanding is going up. That is a bit of a concern, but as long as they're growing, not a big deal. For their balance sheet here, cash on hand, $800 million. Total current assets, $1.3 billion. Great to see. Total assets, $1.6. Now, compared to their liabilities, we have current liabilities of only $300 million, which is unreal. Less than their current assets and less than their cash on hand. Crazy stuff. Total debt as well. Actually, no long-term debt here, which is great. And total liabilities, $480 million. Really not bad at all. I mean, they're not going bankrupt anytime soon here. And for their cash flow statement as well, bring down the net income number of $260 million. Cash from operations, $289 million. Very similar. Great there. CapEx, a little bit, $20 million. Not bad at all. Don't mind if that's even higher, honestly. Of course, they're issuing a little stock. There's a little debt as well. They're not buying back right now, but it's probably not the best time to buy back. They want to really reinvest back into their business, which I would say is the correct decision. Free cash flow per share here, also positive, now finally growing, which is great to see. Normal free cash flow, of course, positive as well, almost $300 million. Now, of course, the stock is down for a reason. Morningstar did a pretty good analysis report here of the company and the stock. They're saying the fair value is around $36 a share. This was back in June here. Now, of course, we're closely approaching 36. We're now the low 50s, high 40s here, depending on when you're watching this video. So we're getting there. We're getting to the fair value. What do they say? They discuss Celsius's impressive volume share gains in North America. Okay. They believe that there isn't a true competitive edge, but there's still a very strong brand and demand for them in North America, and that could expand to other countries across the world. They say their better-for-you fitness-oriented product portfolio complements consumers' preference for wellness-oriented offerings. So if it's complementing it, that's pretty good to see. It should still have some demand there. Again, Celsius should continue to expand its distribution points through the PepsiCo network, facilitating growth through entry into new markets. That's good. And investments in branded cooler placements should enhance Celsius's in-store visibility, while continued product investments could bolster brand loyalty even further. But bears also say, due to the category's capacity for innovation, Celsius must deploy higher levels of marketing and R&D spending to remain competitive, signaling the significant brand investment required to stay relevant, which could cap the firm's profit prospects, which is true as well. But as I said, the CapEx spending in relation to their profit and free cash flow is actually not that bad. They have room to potentially increase that spending just a little bit. Success in international markets may be difficult due to the differences in taste preferences, which of course could go for anything. Monster's market dominance as well, and PepsiCo's less robust beverage distribution prowess relative to Coca-Cola and regulatory scrutiny in the US and Europe might diminish the firm's brand, especially with its narrow category focus, which I don't think is that big of a concern there. But overall, they're gaining market share. The key is, how much market share can they gain against those giants like Red Bull and Monster Energy? Now, here's the current option volume for Celsius puts and calls here. Of course, I'm looking more at the calls right now because we're trading in this range here, right around $50 a share as of recording this video. A lot of call option buying for the August expiration here at $55 a share. This could be seen as an anchor point, but also a point of resistance where there's a lot of buying, but a lot of selling as well from investors, market makers, etc. This is going to be pretty interesting to see how Celsius performs in the next month or so, especially with their earnings report in 18 days. If they beat earnings, we are breaking above this resistance for sure. These call buyers will be deep in the money, and the market makers will have to cover, and they're probably already covering these options here because they, you know, they're usually selling the call options to these investors if there aren't enough call options to be sold in the open market. So obviously right now we don't know for sure what's going to happen with Celsius. There is a lot less demand currently. We might have a weaker than expected report here, but that could all be priced in already as the stock is down already 50%. So just watch this $55 to $60 level. It might be a bit difficult breaking above without a stellar report, but if there is a stellar report, then we could easily get back above to 60 up here. A lot less resistance in the 65 to 75 range down here. A lot of put buying at 35, again based on Morningstar's analysis, that's their fair value. Of course, down at 35 based on the current growth trajectory, and if they keep their trends up and they keep these growth rates up, then that's a steal at 35. Now, do we break below 35? Very unlikely, unless there is a complete collapse in the company's brand image, or again, if there's some new regulation based on these caffeinated drinks, which I doubt is going to happen, and that would affect a lot of other companies as well, not just Celsius. That would bring us below 35, but other than that, a bad report. We drop down in 18 days to 35 here. A lot of support right here. I would definitely be a buyer down at 35. And for people who like to buy call options, I understand why you do. It is risky, but you could make a lot of money. But based on what I'm looking at here for a lot of stocks right now, especially Celsius, the implied volatility for these options, so high. But if you're selling options, you're collecting that super juiced up premium right now, and over time, as long as there isn't any crazy move in the stock, you would collect and probably make a lot more money selling options than you would straight up buying the stock here. So if you buy a leap for Celsius, it's a little cheaper, but even the leaps, the options that expire out in January 2025, they're still a bit more expensive than what they normally are down there. The darker gray line is the historical implied volatility for Celsius. So all options, especially the shorter term options for Celsius, are a lot more expensive than normal. So that's why selling the options probably is the better bet at current levels. Now, of course, with the chart here, it has been looking pretty good since we bottomed back around May 2022. We had a little bit of a high in November of 2021. But of course, most of the massive growth has been in these past 2 years here. But now, with this little double top here coming right back down to this decent support, a lot of volume here. Again, as I said, at around $50 a share, maybe just below at $49 a share. I mean, the RSI is low. You could see that as a buy, but sometimes the RSI being low doesn't mean you should just buy in because it's oversold. Sometimes it's oversold for a reason. There's a lot of negative momentum in the stock right now. The MACD also, again, looks to be maybe good, but not entirely. I want to see a bit more verification of some type of good cross here. Of course, you could look at technicals all day. Sometimes doesn't matter, because if the company is not performing as expected, the stock's going to go down no matter what technicals you're looking at here. So we're below the 200-day moving average. We're below actually all of our recent moving averages, the 20-day, the 50-day I have on the chart here. So not looking too good, but at some point there could be a reversal if growth is still there and the stock is still down and it becomes a lot better of a value proposition. The, you know, valuation itself, the PE ratios are a lot lower and the growth is still kind of there, maybe a bit slower than expected, but still super fast, then that would be a time to, you know, look past the FUD, the fear, uncertainty, and doubt, and buy the dip in the stock. Now, what exactly are some good options placed here with Celsius stock? What I would do, again, as I said, is of course sell some options. You could sell a, you know, call credit spread if you believe that the stock will stay below a certain strike price over the next couple of weeks and months here. What I'll be doing is a bit more simpler, a bit more easier to manage, I would say. It's just straight up selling a put option. So first off, the expiration date I'll do, it's going to be about 33 days out here, August 23rd. We're going to go down to a pretty low strike price here. We're currently trading at, again, $49 a share. Let's go down to, you know, closer to where we believe fair value is, the low 40s, maybe high 30s. So 42, 41, not a lot of premium actually down here. So we'll do 42 right now. It's actually zero open interest. Not many people have this contract here. Apparently no one actually, and the volume is three there. So interesting stuff, but regardless, if I sell this put option here, I'm collecting $152 up front. Of course, a contract controls 100 shares of the stock, so it says $1.52, but you always multiply that by 100 to get $152. So no matter what happens, I'm collecting $152 into my account, no questions asked. Now, if Celsius stock by August 23rd is above $42 a share, I keep all my money and I don't have to buy the stock. But if it's at $42 or below by August 23rd, I have to buy 100 shares of Celsius at $42 a share. Now, of course, why would I do that? I believe that Celsius is still a solid company to own, that at $42, it's a lot better of a buy than it is at $49 a share, and there's still growth, and I don't mind holding the stock for the next couple of years. And actually, you don't even have to hold the stock, because let's say you get assigned the shares, you collect $150 up front. What you could do is turn around and sell a call and collect money on the shares you already own. So if I bought at $42, I could sell a call up here. These, you know, premiums are going to be a bit different, of course, but let's say again, we sell a call at $52 a share. I have to own 100 shares to sell a call, or I can own a leap option. But regardless, if I own those 100 shares, I could turn around, sell a call, get $260 for owning the shares. And as long as Celsius is below $52 by expiration date, I also keep the $260 I collected. But if Celsius is above 52, then I have to sell my shares. But of course, I got assigned, I bought the shares at $43 a share, so I'm making money on the share price appreciation, and I'm also making money on the selling of the options. So again, that's the wheel strategy in essence. But overall, if you don't want to sell your shares, you want to buy in Celsius, you want to keep the shares for the long term, you would make sure you sell a call at higher strike prices so you don't get assigned those shares. You would sell the call at, you know, deltas that are a bit low, so there's a less chance of the call option being in the money by expiration. A lot of stuff I could break down for options. Let me know down below if you want to do that more in depth in future videos. But in essence here, Celsius seems to be a pretty interesting opportunity. Of course, would I go all in at current prices? No. Would I sell puts at lower strike prices? That seems to be a lot better of a strategy in my opinion. So let me know down below your opinions on Celsius as a company, as a brand. Is it just a drink company? Are you not going to buy at all? Do you not care about the stock whatsoever? Do you believe there is a lot more upside and this 50% drop is a great time to slowly add in? Are you going to play some options on this? Let me know down below. Be sure to subscribe for more stock analysis videos like this, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, guys.